everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and we are celebrating spring, even though we have been tricked a couple of times going from winter to spring to winter to spring to winter to spring. I know that's going on in a lot of places. Today we are going to be transplanting seedlings. In March, when it looked like it was never going to be here, I started planting seeds. And I wanted to get a head start on some squash seeds and some broccoli, which I've never grown before, and also with some tomato seeds that I saved from last year from one of our favorite tomatoes, Mr. Stripey. And so I have several different ways that I have started the plants. Some of them in the other room I started right in pots. Some of them I started in a growing system such as this, which has a water system underneath that keeps the that black material wet. And you saw all the roots that are coming. And so when I transplant those, I'm trying to save those roots so the plant doesn't have to start all over again and put them into a bigger pot. Now, this is a cow pot made out of cow poop, sometimes called cow pies. This is a pot container that you can use, and then you plant this whole thing in the ground, and it decomposes and kind of nourishes your plant at the same time. It's very ecologically wonderful. And it'll disintegrate, and you will see when I take it out of these pots, I only put it in here temporarily, the roots will be coming out already. And so it's wonderful if you're doing something like sunflowers, if you're starting those indoors, they don't like to be moved. So if you can move the whole thing and pot the whole thing into the ground, the sunflowers will be happy. Now you may see a variety of coats over here too. This is spring, that's winter, it never ends. Anyway, these are the Mr. Stripey tomato plants, and I planted the seeds for them. Some of them don't have their second leaves yet, or their true leaves. Some are beginning to. What's tricky about them is that when you take them out of here, like I said, you want to keep as much of the root system involved. So I'm helping it along by just loosening up the sides. And then I'll lift it up and push it out while I'm pulling, just lightly pulling them up. Come on. You have to coax them out because look. There are my roots. They're wonderful, and you don't want to lose those. With tomatoes, the deeper you put them, the better. Get in there. And roots will form off of the stem of a tomato. So if you plant it all the way up to the leaves, you're going to have roots coming out wherever the soil touches the stem. Thank you, sir. Now you'll notice that in some of these pots there are more than one, and that's okay, because as you can see with this one, maybe one of them will be stronger than the other, and if that's the case, then I can just snip that off and let one main plant take over. But one never knows if one or both of them are going to make it, so if you have multiples, it gives you a better chance.
That's almost like an aquaponic system that you have going over
there. It is. It truly is.
Can you lift that one tray once?
Sure.
I just want to look at all those roots in there. I mean, it is amazing.
And that's because there is this fabric underneath, and it dips down on the ends into a supply of water.
So you actually fill that tray with water.
I fill the tray up with water.
It soaks into that.
Right, and it keeps it wet, so that they can continue to grow. All right. Let's see if
if I can get this guy out. Here he comes. It's, yeah, some of his roots are still in there, but some are not. So I'm going to put them as deep as I can into this soil, and then...
Thank you for saying soil.
You're welcome.
You know, I'm not as rich as I used to be, because every time Lynn would say the D word, I would get a quarter.
I'm not as rich as I used to be either because of that.
Well, think of it. Do you really want to plant stuff in dirt? I mean, that's like the dirt under your carpet.
There is not dirt under my carpet.
Well, that's what you refer to it. When you vacuum clean, what are you doing? You're not vacuuming up the soil.
Mostly it's dog hair. So this is the tomato. Okay. Then a flower that I'm also planting, I got from seeds, and these were called Zinnia Cut and Come. So these particular zinnias are encouraging cutting off the flowers as they come out, and then they will continue flowering as long as the whole season goes. I mean, zinnias go from, oh, probably early July, would you say, mm-hmm. until they're killed by the frost. So with zinnias, I'll plant these at the level that they're at. And I don't care that there's three in there. I probably will just plant them and just let them go right next to each other.
Now, you make your own mixture, right?
Well, I do. And with soil, you can use prepared bagged soil.
Potting soil?
Potting soil. But then I also add perlite, and that's these little white specks that you see. It's a mineral, it's very light, and it keeps the soil...
Well, it retains water, right?
It does, but it also helps your plants drain. It kind of does both things.
Aerate?
It adds air, yes. And that's what you see when you buy plants at the store. If you bought somebody a plant, you'd see that it has... all those little white specks in it, that's perlite. And then you don't want to use the soil right out of the bag. You need to wet it first, because otherwise your roots on your plants are going to dry out because the soil's too dry. And then you water it and you think, oh, you know, well, I've watered it, but you've only watered the surface, and then you need to stir it up. Hence, my hands are dirty. Or shall I say, soily?
Soily?
My hands are soily.
That would be true. Your hands are dirty.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. I love to tease my wife.
Yes, he does.
I think I do a pretty good job of it. Somebody has to.
Why?
Well... that's why men were invented.
Ah, I see.
And it'd be too easy otherwise for all the beautiful women watching. I mean, you know, hey, gotta tease them. I only tease the people I love.
This is true. This is very true. Then another thing that I planted back here are Mexican sunflowers. Now, these are the ones that come up. And by the end of the summer, they're this tall, perhaps.
Oh, easily.
And they're just filled.
Thousands and thousands of flowers.
Yes.
I was so impressed the first year we grew those.
And these are perennials.
It's like a bush.
Yes.
It truly is a bush.
Well, you can see these stems are very sturdy. And then the root system is lovely. They're very healthy looking. They're very tough. So I am not concerned with these or how they'll do because I know they'll do well. They like sun. All of these like sun. The tomatoes, the zinnias, and these Mexican sunflowers. Now, these don't get big heads on them. They're like this big.
But they're a silver prolific.
Dollar. Yes. They're just prolific.
Well, I think we've highlighted them in several videos in the past, especially mm-hmm. during our monthly garden tours.
Now, this one I planted in high hopes that it would be wonderful because I love pansies. And they were coated seeds. Usually I don't buy coated, meaning they're encapsulated.
I think inoculated, right?
No, I don't think they're inoculated. They're called pelletized because it makes the tiny seed easier to see where you've planted it. You can plant them one at a time, or you can easily see that the seeds are there.
Hmm.
Well, they didn't do a thing. They have been sitting here as long as everything else in this back row, nothing. And these were on a heat pad, and they were under grow lights. But again, you never know. Those, we're going to try them again, but we're going to try planting them in a different way. Maybe they just needed more sun. This is another growing system I use this year. This is called a biodome. I believe it's from Park Seed. What you have is this little dome that you can close the vents to keep it very moist in there while your seeds are just beginning before they germinate. And I've had some success. Now, these were all yarrow. These seeds were so, so very tiny that you just sprinkle them on the top of the sponge, and these are coxcomb that Scott Miller gave me last year, and I didn't get to plant them, so I planted them this year. Thank you, Scott, and they came up nicely. I also had some blackberry lilies from Phyllis that we were hoping would grow, but they didn't seem to like to grow indoors, so I'm going to try them again outdoors. We'll see. Now, these are a little tricky to get out. There's holes in the bottom, and they float around in the water. As you can see, here's the watermark. And you have to get your finger under there, and then this whole little sponge comes out. And then you just plant the whole sponge. Get up there. And again, it keeps the roots intact. It's easier on the plant. Okay. And then that was the yarrow. This is the coxcomb. Very beautiful. Colorful. This is an annual. The yarrow is a perennial. So that means the yarrow will come back every year. And the coxcomb is an annual, so you have to plant those again next year. Our last system for planting, besides being outdoors, is to try planting them in a box. And this box is Arnold Palmer tea drink. Rick doesn't drink tea in a normal situation, but this is tea, and it's lemonade together, and he really loves it. But these boxes are really handy. They come wrapped so that underneath here is all plastic. They're sturdy, and when we put it outside, of course, we'll take the plastic off and just let the seed roots go into the soil. Probably have to poke some holes, and we're going to try these. And it's important that if you've not planted things before and you don't know what they're going to look like, it's really important to label them. So I'm going to label that, and then this giant Swiss pansy that didn't work out when I planted it indoors, we'll plant it in this situation, see if it works, and I'll still have a few left, and I'll try them outside.
Well, I think it's an interesting idea that you have, because you know, sometimes when you plant seeds outside, the birds
Eat them, and they get washed away. Yeah. This way you can make your own little arrangement of, like, a flower arrangement growing, as long as the plants aren't really huge. I mean, that wouldn't work.
Well, we're going to try this technique with bulbs, too.
We are. We're going to try a little bit with bulbs. So I'm going to start with these, and these are, like I said, they're pelletized. So you can see how easy they are to see compared to just the seeds themselves, which I'll show you with the ice plant, which are teeny, tiny, teeny. And these get to be 6 to 8 inches tall. Both of them do, but because they are such different kinds, I'm going to put these in the middle. And you just have to press them into the soil. They don't want to be way down in, but I'm not going to press them in until I get my ice plant planted as well. These are not perennials, as far as I know. It'll just be fun to see how they turn out. And then with the ice plant, looks really cool. There's supposedly neon. They are a succulent kind of plant, kind of like moss roses. Okay, so they only get a little bit tall, and then these have flowers, which I've never seen these before.
I call them, rosmoses.
Yeah. All right, you can see how tiny these are. So these won't get covered at all. If you covered them, they would not get enough sun, and they would never grow. So I'm just sprinkling them around the edges. I'm guessing that they will grow over the edge, because they are like a sedum. Maybe that's enough. Okay, now I can press in these pansy seeds, and maybe separate them a little bit.
Because they're pelletized, do they have a tendency to stick together?
No. Mm-mm. No. Now, you can get seeds that are treated, and they too come in a pellet, and they're treated for funguses, to prevent fungus and all sorts of other things. I prefer not to get that kind, but these are just pelletized because they're so tiny. And it just makes them easier to
And then do you just plant. Smooth the soil out after that? Or
No, they don't want to be too far under, it said. So you just kind of press them in. And once they start growing, of course, their roots will take over. And so when we go to, when we water these, we're going to use a sprayer. Because we don't want to disturb them. We don't want to blow them away.
Well, that's another thing too. I mean, you've got a lot of factors if you're planting outdoor: the wind, the birds, yep. And other little critters.
The rain.
Yeah, and the rain could wash them away.
Oop, hello.
Just have to remember to push the button so it turns it off.
Well, I try not to push it all the way down, because then you get a steady stream.
Right.
If I kind of tap it, it'll spray it very lightly. Okay, so now where are all of these plants going to grow, and what is going to happen with these tomatoes? If these don't bring themselves up after they've adjusted to being pulled out of their home, then we will have to stake them. And you'll see when we go to the plant room that my squash are being staked right now, because they are getting big.
Steak and potatoes?
No.
Oh.
Off to the plant room they go, where they will be under grow lights and kept warm by the indoor of the house. So here we go. Ooh, this one's a heavy one. This room room has been an office. It's been a bedroom for all three of our kids at one time or another. And now it is a plant room and a storage room. You can see that these are my squash. These are my broccoli. And I just transplanted these today, so they're still in their wilty stage. Hopefully they will snap.
But those are the ones you've staked.
Yes. I've staked them since they were a little bit even smaller. But and then here's the ones we did today. Oops. Don't get crooked on me. And here is our experimental box garden. We hope you enjoyed transplanting seedlings, and perhaps you've learned something or just been entertained while it might be snowing. If you did, please give us a thumbs up. Also, we'd like to invite you to our website, which is wisconsingarden.com, where you can see over 1,000 videos of us, and you can binge out on it, and we really appreciate if you did that. Also, we'd like to invite you to subscribe to our subscribe to our channel, and if you would remember to tap that little bell up there, and it'll let you know when we have put up a new video. We already know what our next video will be, because we are going to be planting trees. They're coming tomorrow. Bye for now.
Connect with us on YouTube.